गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव बीन डूइंग द चैप्टर द एड्रेस. यस्टरडे आई टोल्ड यू अबाउट द फर्स्ट मीटिंग ऑफ द नरेटर एट हाउस नंबर 46. द एड्रेस गिवन इन दिस चैप्टर, शी मेट मिसिज डॉर्लिंग हु डिड नॉट एंटरटेन द गर्ल. द गर्ल वॉज मिसिंग हर मदर सो मच, शी वॉन्टेड टू सी ऑल दोज पोजेशंस विच वर लेफ्ट बाई हर मदर एट दैट वेरी एड्रेस. And when after the futile meeting of first time, she decided to go there for the second time. And this time, when she reached Mrs. Darling's home, a girl of 15 years opened the door. The narrator asked her about her mother and she told her that she was outside doing some job, to which the narrator decided that she would wait for her. The narrator followed the girl along the passage. There was a Hanukkah. Hanukkah means a candle holder which was hung next to the mirror. She remembered that she never used it, as if it was very unmanageable. The girl asked her to sit down as she opened the door for the living room. She stopped and she was disturbed. She was very much upset because she was standing in a room which she knew and she did not. She knew and she did not. What is this? She was familiar with all the objects, all the pieces of furniture lying in that very room, but they were put up in such an awkward manner that she did not want to identify them. She was standing in the middle of things which she did not want to see, and they burdened her. Maybe because of the way things were arranged, or the humid smell in the room, or the ugly furniture, she was scared to look at everything. She sat down on a chair which the girl pulled out for her. She looked at the woolen tablecloth and she rubbed it, and her fingers felt warm because it was woolen. And the girl told her that the mother would be back soon. Yes, one more thing. As she followed the lines of the pattern, she was checking the design of the tablecloth. She remembered there was one burn mark on one corner of this tablecloth, and she was finding that only. The girl told her that her mother would be back soon and asked if she would like to have a cup of tea. She answered, "Thank you." The narrator looked up. She saw the girl put two cups of tea in front of her. She had a broad back just like her mother. She poured tea from the teapot and it had a gold border on the lid. She opened a box and took some spoons out of it. The narrator complimented the girl about the box. She felt that hearing her own voice was looking very weird, very strange. It was sounding different to her. As the girl turned to give her a cup, she asked if she knew about the box. Then she added that it is antique, according to her mother. She pointed around the room and said that there are more. She told her to see. Although the narrator did not need to follow her direction, she knew that what she was talking about. She glanced over the tea table. She remembered how she used to fancy the apple on that pewter plate, that gray-colored metal plate. And the girl shared that they used the plate for everything. It was for multi-purpose. Once they ate of the plates that were hanging on the wall. The girl wanted to eat off that plate too, but it was not anything special. The narrator found the burn mark on the tablecloth. The girl looked at her in a question what she was searching. The narrator said yes and told her that when you are used to, when you are habitual touching things into your house, you hardly notice anything. You only notice when something is missing or it needs to be repaired, or because you have lent it to someone else. She again found her voice to be very unnatural. She continued. She told the girl that once her mother asked her if she would help her polish the silver utensils. It was a long time ago and she was bored that day at home. She had to stay that day. Might be she was very ill. She asked her mother what silver she was talking about. Her mother said it was the spoons, the knives and forks, but she did not know that it was of silver. The girl laughed and said that she bet she did not know it was either with what they ate with. The narrator asked if she knew whether the cutlery they have been using, it was of silver. The girl hesitated and walked to the sideboard and opened a drawer. She said she would see if it was there. The narrator jumped and said she forgot the time as she had to catch the train. The girl asked her if she did not want to wait for her mother. The narrator still replied with a no and said she must leave. The girl pulled the drawer open. The narrator said she could find her way out and walked down the passage as she heard the ringing sound of spoons and forks. When she reached the corner of the road, she looked at the nameplate again. It said Marconi Street and she was standing at house number 46. The address was correct, but she does not want to remember it anymore. She did not want to go back as the things in there reminded her of memories linked with the familiar life of old times. It was connected with very sweet memories, but they lose the value when you are separated from them and you see them again in strange environment. She thought of what she would have done with a small rented room where the blackout papers were still hanging over the windows and no cutlery fitted in the narrow drawers. She finally decided to forget the address forever, and it would make her life easy. That's why she forgot the address forever. Thank you.